Nadimul Haque.
Vice Chairman, sir, I thank you for permitting me to speak on this important issue of the Indo-Nepal relations. Sir, after 10 years of civil war and the 9-year-long initiative of framing a new constitution, it was hoped that Nepal would enter into an era of peace and progress in a democratic and federal structure. However, the Madhesis and the Tharus, residents of Terai Plains, have been protesting against the provisions of the constitution relating to federalism, political representation, citizenship and inclusion. Sir, while we cannot ignore our centuries-old relation with Nepal, we must also take into consideration the fact that the Madhesis and Tharus have social, cultural, religious links with Indians living across the border. The interim constitution of Nepal of 2007 provided for the proportionate inclusion of Madhesis and other similarly situated groups in the state organs. But the present constitution does not have such a provision. The present constitution provides that only citizens by descent will be eligible to hold public offices like the President, Prime Minister, Chief Justice, Chief Secretary, and Chief of other bodies, etc. This clause may have a discriminatory effect on Madhesis because it excludes many of them who have acquired citizenship by naturalization. Citizenship by naturalization is primarily acquired by those who are born to a Nepali parent and a foreigner. Typically, Madhesis tend to marry persons from across the Indo-Nepal border. As my colleagues were saying, ki roti beti ka rishta hai. Sir, in demarcating the 7 provincial boundaries, their constitution has merged 12 of the 20 districts of the Terai region with various hill provinces. The Madhesis and Tharus are arguing that this would allow hill districts to dominate in their provinces and deprive them of resources. In the light of this issue, India expressed concerns at the protests in October 2015, also at the United Nations Human Rights Council in November 2015, India had recommended that the government of Nepal should accommodate all sections of Nepal in the constitution building process. It is pertinent to mention that before raising the emerging issues in India-Nepal relation at an international level, it would have been better for our government to continue the process of dialogue with the government of Nepal, keeping in mind the long-standing, friendly, bilateral relations between us, in as much as China has since started fishing in troubled waters. Sir, India and Nepal have agreements with regard to trade and commerce, sharing of river waters, energy cooperation, investment protection, etc. India has also exported petroleum products, motor vehicles, spare parts, etc. to the tune of around 28,000 crores, whereas it has imported polyester yarns, textiles, jutes and other products for around 4,000 crores in 2014-15. It is therefore of mutual interest that both countries should explore all means to resolve the contentious issues, and sooner it is done, it would be better for both the countries. Sir, Nepal shares its borders with 5 Indian states, that is West Bengal, Sikkim, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, and Uttarakhand. Bengal shares its borders with 3 countries, sir, that is Bangladesh, Bhutan, and Nepal. So on a side note, it has to be noted that this is a very sensitive area, and any cut in state funding is also affecting police modernization in this area. But coming back to the larger issue, sir, there are a large number of people of Nepalese origin who reside both permanently and temporarily in India, particularly in these 5 states, in a conducive atmosphere of amity and fraternity. The Madhesis in Nepal are our brothers, and we should have a duty towards them. In this background, we welcome the meeting between our Minister of External Affairs with their Deputy Prime Minister and Foreign Minister of Nepal recently, where discussions were held on 4 key issues, concerning the madrasis, that is one, constituency delimitation, two, political representation, three, citizenship, and four, demarcation of provinces. Sir, my party sincerely hopes and believes that considering the warmth exuded by the Indian government during the April 2015 earthquake in Nepal, a similar gesture would be extended by the government of Nepal for betterment of relations with India. Sir, I rest my case.
Thank you very much.